Hey guys, so today's video is all about appendicitis. We're going to be talking about what it is, what causes it, what the symptoms are, how it's diagnosed, and what can happen if it's left untreated. So it's a super important video, and also if you do think you have appendicitis, you need to speak to your healthcare professional as soon as possible. So let's begin. Now before we begin, if you do want to find any specific information quite quickly, because I imagine this is that kind of video where you might want to find out exactly what the symptoms are or how it's diagnosed or how it's treated, I am gonna leave a full breakdown in the description below. So click on it and click on any point of information that you want just to get you to that information quicker. Let's begin. So appendix removal is actually one of the most common procedures done worldwide. And the appendix is found on the lower right abdomen. It's just a little pouch that comes off the large intestine. So your large intestine is part of your digestive system, and it absorbs all the water from the food, and it also absorbs some electrolytes, and then it pushes all that waste food down towards your rectum. Now your appendix, as I mentioned earlier, is towards the lower right abdomen. So just down here, you can't really see it in the angle, but it's the lower right quadrant of your abdomen, and it starts at the start of the large intestine, so it's a little pouch. And to be honest with you, the actual function of the appendix is not very well understood. So unlike everything else in the digestive system, which we understand what it does, the appendix, no one really knows what the purpose of it is. So some scientists believe that the appendix is what we call a vestigial organ, so it's no longer really required, it has no purpose. However, some other scientists believe that the appendix is where all the good bacteria is stored. So as you can see, no one really fully understands the purpose of it. So the next question is, what is appendicitis? Well, appendicitis is basically the inflammation, the swelling of the appendix, and the cause of it is usually unknown. It's expected that about 50% of cases are caused by some form of blockage, and that blockage can be, for example, an enlarged lymph node within the intestine, within the large intestine that's causing that blockage, or there might be some food waste that's compacted in there and it's causing that blockage, which then causes that swelling. Now, appendicitis is most often seen in patients between 10 to 30 years old. However, it can happen at any age as well. So don't think, oh, I'm not in that age group and it doesn't apply to me, because it can happen at any age group. And the other thing is that sometimes when you have appendicitis, it can burst as well. The appendix can burst, and this can be very painful. And I'm going to discuss this a bit later on. So now let's look at the symptoms of appendicitis. To begin with appendicitis, most people, and by that I say most people, because with abdominal pain, the pain can vary for different people. That's really important for you to remember, that you might not have these typical symptoms, you might have different symptoms, and it could be appendicitis. But for most people, the pain begins around the belly button area. There's some pain, there's some discomfort, and then after a few days the pain can go to the lower right abdominal side, which is below the belly button on the right side, and it can be quite painful. It can be painful to cough, it can be painful to walk, and sometimes some patients, when they press on the area and release, the pain can be quite agonizing as well. But these are the typical symptoms, but not everyone can have these symptoms too, so please do remember that. You may also experience a few other symptoms, for example, a fever, nausea, vomiting, flushing, constipation, a loss of appetite. These symptoms can vary for different people, and the list does go on, so I'm gonna leave more information in the description below for you as well. So moving on to diagnosis, look, it can be a little tricky to diagnose appendicitis, and you should definitely not do it yourself. You should always speak to your healthcare professional. When you do speak to them, it can vary on what they do to test for it. For example, if you have typical symptoms of appendicitis, which we spoke about earlier, one test that I always do is I always touch the lower right abdomen, and you press on it gently, and when I release, it's really painful for the patient. That is what you call a typical symptom of appendicitis, and it's really easy and quick to diagnose, and it will send you on your way to hospital because it needs inspecting. However, please remember that 50% of patients are what we call atypical, so their symptoms aren't like the typical symptoms that are associated with appendicitis. Some patients have pain around their liver area, some people have pain around their intestine area. So it's very different, and it's very difficult to diagnose from a YouTube video telling you about these symptoms. So this is a very broad sort of aspect of symptoms for you to be aware of, and just remember that the symptoms are always typical. You might not have the sort of typical symptoms that everyone's used to for appendicitis. So the moral of the story is that if you have any sort of signs and symptoms, any sort of abdominal pain, any of the normal symptoms that we spoke about, you need to speak to your healthcare professional. Please don't try and self-diagnose yourself with appendicitis. This is the worst thing that you can possibly do, because your health is the most important thing. So please do speak to your healthcare professional. If you experience any symptom of abdominal pain, anything out of the ordinary, any of the symptoms that we spoke about, and any of the atypical symptoms that we spoke about, that's the most important thing. And in this situation, your healthcare professional might do a blood test, they might do a urine test, they might do a CT scan, an ultrasound, they might even do a laparoscopy where a small incision is made and a small camera is put in just to see what's going on there, so they can physically see if the appendix is inflamed or not. I will leave more information on diagnosis as well if you are interested, but like I say, the moral of the story is, if you have any symptoms, please do speak to your healthcare professional. It's just a phone call and then they'll get you in for an examination, and it's super quick. And like I said, your health is the most important thing. Now the next question is, how is appendicitis treated? So if you've gone to hospital and they've diagnosed you with appendicitis, most commonly they're going to treat you straight away by doing an appendicectomy. This is the removal of the appendix. It's a minor surgical procedure, and like I said, it's one of the most common surgical procedures done. Sometimes as well, they may choose to remove your appendix even without making a diagnosis, just because sometimes it's safer to reduce the chance of it bursting. So please bear that in mind as well. Now the good news is that this is a very common procedure done here in the UK and worldwide, so don't worry too much about it. It's usually done by open surgery or by a keyhole. Most commonly it's done by a keyhole, but this is determined on an individual basis. And recovery time is quite quick. It takes a couple of weeks. And if you are wanting more information about the surgery, I am gonna leave loads more info in the description below. So if that interests you, click on there and give it a quick read. So the next question is, what happens if you leave appendicitis untreated? Because I know the thought of surgery can be quite daunting, but please remember this. If you do leave appendicitis untreated, it can actually be life-threatening. And this is serious stuff, because what can happen is that infection can get worse, the abscess can grow, and it can burst, and it can become life-threatening. So for example, you can get something called peritonitis. This is where the lining of the abdomen becomes infected from the burst appendix. That bacteria is gonna go onto the lining, and then that can become infected, which can then spread to your other organs and damage them. So as you can see, it's severe, it's life-threatening. Another thing that can happen is the abscess where the appendix is can just keep getting bigger and bigger as the pus forms in there and collects. As your body tries to fight that bacteria, there's gonna be more and more pus collecting in the abscess, which again, it can eventually burst and also cause so much inflammation down there and so much pain. And lastly, if appendicitis is left untreated, it can actually cause something called sepsis, which is again life-threatening, where our body's immune system overreacts. This can be very life-threatening, and it can happen in about 17 to 32% of appendicitis patients. So the moral of the story is, if you experience any abdominal pain, any abdominal discomfort, anything out of the ordinary, go with your gut feeling and go and speak to your healthcare professional so they can examine you, so they can diagnose you and find out exactly what is going on. It might not be appendicitis, it might be something else, but the most important thing is that you do speak to your healthcare professional. I will also leave more information in the description below on when you should seek medical advice, and more importantly, when you should seek emergency medical advice. So please do read it. This is super important, because your health is the most important thing. So that's the end of this week's video. I really hope you found this information helpful. You now know all about the appendix, what it does, well, what it doesn't do, the symptoms of appendicitis, the diagnosis, the treatment, what happens if it's left untreated, when to seek medical advice, and loads more. You're a bit of an appendix pro now, so you know everything there is. So please make sure you do the right thing. Thank you for watching. As always, I will see you next week, and always sending you awesome vibes. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.